God.
That's present.
Respected MD. Respected Mr. Chai. Respected Satish and respected Cha. And all the dignitaries on the floor. My heart is full. I really do not know whether I deserve these kind of appreciation from you. But you have loaded my heart with a lot of inputs and messages. So my heart is heavy. With a heavy mind, I am starting my last speech. When I was discussing with the people today, many said that always I used to give a story. Most of my speeches will have a story and a message and a moral. So today is not going to be a different thing. But only thing is today I'm going to give my story. I do not know whether my story is going to give any moral or messages to you. But I want to give clear message to you people based on my experience, which is going to be given as a flashback now. So I am going to rewind last 20 years. Victor, you said 5 minutes time for me. Can I take more or?
I didn't say like that.
Sir. You have an agenda. I didn't say. Please bear with me if I am taking too much of time. As I said, this is my last speech in Hyundai Attiver as a director of Hyundai Attiver. I think I have the privilege of taking more time, but I do not want to bore you people with two long stories. It is the learning which I happened to gain in HMI and Hyundai Attiver. So it is not on right on my part if I am not sharing the learnings with you. So kindly bear with me. As you all know, I am the first employee of IT HMIL. I had the privilege of joining this organization when HMIL project started as a barren land. I was supposed to leave for US 10 days down the line for an assignment at Chicago. My H1 parents already got, I received H1 thing. That was the time I got a call from Hyundai. I thought, okay, this is an opportunity, something is coming on my way. And my mother felt me being in India is better for her. So I will be close to the family. So that was her wish. So I wanted to give weightage for that. So I attended the interview and then the story started. I never heard Hyundai at the time. That was the time MNCs started coming to India. So with a lot of expectation and hopes, I joined this organization. And today I feel I had taken a right decision by choosing Indian career in MNC organization with HMI than not leaving, to leave to US. Very first day, we had interview with the media people. In fact, even now I have that newspaper article where myself and Mr. Ejesio gave an interview to the media, what Hyundai Motor India's plan in terms of IT. Why I am saying this, that is the kind of freedom and privilege given to me even on the first day. I was part of the interview and we, though I was not sure what is the plans of HMI at the time, Mr. Seo shared, and in fact when the interview was going on, they were asking what is the total investment, IT investment. Initially, Mr. Seo was not familiar with the number of zeros. This I noticed most of the Korean when they come to India, when we discuss million or billion, they always have confusion whether it is denoting the six zeros or seven zeros. So he wrote me and he asked me what is this. Then I said $5 million. So we said HMIL IT investment in India is going to be $5 million. Then next day that article was a big article. Being the first person, you always have the advantage. So I had that advantage of setting up IT. That gave me a lot of experience in terms of forming the organization, in terms of setting up the infrastructure, in terms of getting exposure to the technology. Those days, compared to Indian organization, MNCs have come with a lot of technological plans, and Hyundai is not an exception. I was handling most of the technical part initially. Today I am proud to say that many of the technical implementations I can handle, because those days, whether it is a VSAT, whether it is a micro tower based communication, whether it is any various ERPs or the plant wide network, countrywide setting up of dealership, everything, we were together, along with Mr. Seo, we were together doing the evaluation part, selection part. At the time we got guideline from Korea. I was told for an organization of 2.5 lakhs car, Hyundai Korea decided AS400 as the platform. So if it is going to be multiple of 2.5, every 2.5 lakh cars, we will have AS400 platform to take care of the load. Being in India, they were concerned about packages, commercial packages, Hacha and finance. So at the time, the decision was, but for HR and finance, all other applications will run on AS400. HR and finance, we need to identify and select a suitable ERP. So in that context, we went around the thing, we evaluated various and finally decided on JD Edwards for financials and Ranko Marshall for HR. Why I am saying this is, that is the freedom given to us in terms of finding solutions. So we were all doing this. So I had the privilege of working independently without deviating the guidelines and directions of HQ, yet address to the requirements. It was a pleasant journey. Same is the case of setting up organization. Today I can proudly say we started this organization in every phase, you name it, I can tell you. We went for people with a good attitude and good mind to work. We never look for experience in the required field. When we have selected people for an AS400, all the persons, none of them had AS400 experience. But what we have done is, we had given an initial basic training to all the people in AS400. Later on, it was a success story. What I'm trying to say is, it is the always our objective and intention was to give opportunity to the employee, and every individual is capable of catching fast. That we were able to prove time and again, whether it is AS400 or whether it is a Lotus Notes or SAP, that was the strategy we followed. We never went for people with experience, but we gave basic training. Then the competency of the individual got increased. One thing I used to always have in mind, today I'm conveying that, I always get a feedback, the training opportunities in Hyundai Autoware is less. Yes, I admit, but learning opportunities is very high. Training opportunities may be less, but learning opportunities was very high. Every one of you given opportunity to learn the domain, learn the technology on your own. I can say proudly, this is the one which is going to strengthen you, give you a confidence, comfort in execution of your job better. That is the requirement. Mere classroom training is not really going to give that kind of comfort. Am I taking too much of time? Sorry.
Please take your time.
So I think I have given the message one. So message one is learning is going rather than training. Hope you people understand what is training, what is learning. Training is somebody is giving. Learning is you learn. So learning is important. That platform we laid through 20 years. Number two. Yes, 400 resources we were able to, but that was the time Y2K came. I still remember the day on the Y2K day, the entire team, IT team was at the main building. We were closely watching, monitoring what is happening. And as you all know, Australia, first they reported the status. This was monitored by HQ also. Every part of the world, they were reporting Y2K status. Australia, Korea, then India. We were also closely watching, monitoring in terms of what is happening at the ALC side, shop floor side, machinery side, application side. Is there any impact? So we had a planned approach of activity and the people we were doing. Gauri, I think you will remember. After this Y2K, we all had a joint cake-cutting session. Then the slide started. People started, because of the experience, the people started leaving. We had an attrition problem. That was the time, as Satish said, we started deliberating and discussing on how to retain people. As you all know, IT professionals want to work for IT company, and they always felt being IT professional, part of IT company tag is better. So how to break this barrier? That is the time we were coming out various options. One of the options, as Satish said, changing the designation in line with IT and creating an environment that they are in line with, comparable with IT industry. That was the one strategy we followed. We didn't leave it. We started discussing IBM for strategic outsourcing. This I got help from HMC also. I got support from HMC, then along with the HMC's support, we started discussing outsourcing, strategic outsourcing with the IBM. Then one of the options is why to go for outsourcing. Let us form our own organization. Blessing in disguise, or I don't know, that was the time. Hyundai Auto Ebel. No, it is not Hyundai Auto Ebel. It is AES, Auto Ebel Systems, was formed. Here, again, I want to tell when this was formed and when the discussions happened on integration, we listened to people, what will be their concern. And most of them expressed, no sir, we are having Hyundai tag, we cannot, we don't want to be an AES employee. Nobody knows about who is AES. Then we went back to management and said, let us not have AES. AES should have Hyundai as part of the name. This was, why I'm saying is, management always listened your concern with concern, keeping employee in mind, what is your concern. So based on that, whatever name, itself fixed with the Hyundai. I don't know any, Satish may be knowing. That was the, that is how Hyundai, whatever, Hyundai was part of the name. Then we also said, people should not have a feeling of leaving the organization because so much of attachment was there with Hyundai Motors, most of our employees. We don't want to break that. So we discussed with management and said all the auto ever persons will wear only Hyundai uniform, no auto ever uniform. We don't want to separate. I think that is still followed and I think that made us to feel proud when we moved. Though there are many cases where we feel still that we are treated differently, but these things will help in maintaining the same standard. So I started my career as team leader, but as the day progresses, IT grown, we started implementing dealer management system and the management felt IT support at Delhi is required where the major activity of sales happening. So we formed the Delhi team. That was again part of Auto Ebel. So Delhi team formation, Delhi initial resources were provided by Auto Ebel, but HMI IT person continued to be HMI IT. Later we got integrated. So integration was another thing which we went through a difficult phase in terms of having a smooth integration. That was one of my learnings, experience in organizational level integration, what are all the things to be looked at. Like these are all the up story. Like any process you always have down thing also. We started facing problem. Problem is, I don't know it is a problem, this is a perspective. Till 2006 or 2009, HMI saw IT as a resource to support their operations. So whatever required were invested, it was never seen as an expense. Investment was done. The moment Auto Ebel is created, whatever spending on Auto Ebel has been seen by HMI and the management as an expense. This is the down story. This is the time I had very tough time. I never opened this topic with you people. I think now it's time to share. So the same management, when they were investing, spending it, they never thought it is. But the moment, whatever the mindset, every user starting in, it is IT area. Whatever is responsible. Why we have to spend? Why they cannot manage? These kind of issues started coming. This created a lot of problem. But luckily, that phase also we have crossed. Today, that is not there. Thanks to Mr. Choi. Recent past, lot of things, whether it is, I could see the changing trend. IT investment started flowing. Today, everybody feels it is there. It's a need of the business, need of the hour, it is a requirement. So why I'm saying is, when in a business environment, in an organization, in a corporate, many things can happen. We need to go through this struggle. We also went through this struggle. And rest is the story you may be knowing. The prior to AutoEver integration, many of you may not be knowing. After AutoEver integration, setting up city office, setting up development center, or most of you may be knowing. So message two is, as long as we are service provider, we need to start supporting our customer. We will have a lot of things, because it is natural, customer will expect, this is the person I have assigned this job, why he cannot deliver? So the expectation of the customer is there, and our task is to satisfy them. So it is nothing different in whatever or Hyundai or everywhere, this is the same. So I want you people to realize, so we need to balance and start delivering to manage this kind of dynamics. Finally, let me come to the people part. When I said all these things, personally, never I have felt I am going through difficult phase, I am facing challenges. Always I used to take up, okay, what is, we'll see, let us, okay. That kind of approach came to me because of the people all here. You gave me the strength, you gave me the confidence, you gave me the courage to face this kind of thing. With that, many times I used to tell, okay, let us see, let us see. So that kind of confidence came to me because of all of you. And I always see you as not my team members, as my family members. Most of you, when I was part of the final interview, see what is your. So when we recruit every person, we will have what should be the career and how we should develop and how the organization can get benefit. It is not the individual alone, organization also. With that kind of planning that we have done. So that was the process which we followed. In that journey, many times I would have failed in completing or fulfilling the promises or expectation of yours. I take this opportunity to bow in front of you and please pardon me for my failures. Many times I would not have satisfied every one of you, though I tried my level best. So, okay. Now, as you all know, I got retired in May itself, but came my formation came into they started planning to form set up the plant. So I was asked to ask about my preference to support. So I happily took that assignment. Last 7 months I was working on specific assignments like KMA and the GDMS network strengthening kind of thing. I think I have completed that also, and I today stand in front of you with the completeness in my mind and full satisfaction and happy moment. This was possible all because of your support, and today I am here in Hindu mythology. Today is Vaikuntha Ekadasi. People who are leaving the world will straight go to heaven. So I am leaving this organization. But in my case, I am not looking for heaven because I am leaving heaven. So I don't know what is there for me. People who are leaving this world going to heaven, people leaving this organization, me leaving, I am leaving heaven. So that is a heavy feeling. Thanks for organizing this farewell. I am not seeing this as a farewell to me. I am seeing this as an opportunity for me to wish you all farewell in your assignment and come up in your life and become a successful person in your personal life and professional life also. I am purposely leaving my association and acquaintance with people like Satish, because if I start discussing and mentioning about each every one of you, my acquaintance, it is not professional relationship, professional association, it is the more than professional and personal. It goes beyond professional. Same is the case. Whomever I can name it, Sridevi, Gauri, I can say every Ganesh Babu, Subbu, every person I had the privilege of, as you said, involving myself in their family affairs also. So to that extent, as I said, I see always all of you as a family member. Whenever I discuss outside, my team, my whatever, it is always I own this. That is the kind of pride, proud I used to have. I still have that. That is the reason why my heart is heavy. So with this, I conclude my speech. கதை அடிச்சுட்டு போகிறாண்டா அப்படின்னு நினைப்பீங்க.